This update contains a lot of content, fixes many problems, optimizes the half-body dynamic compensation, and improves the rendering parameter adjustment function. Most importantly, the rendering performance is greatly improved this time, because no major rendering problem has been found before. Let's take a look at wrist twist correction. There has been a bug before, thanks to a netizen for feedback. This correction function has been specially introduced in videos. It is not a perfect solution, but it is sufficient for live broadcast of half body. It seems that the wrist will not be distorted, but excessive correction will cause elbow joint distortion. However, the elbow joint cannot be seen from the front, so it is suitable for half-body live broadcast scenes. As you can see, the elbow joint is twisted. The perfect solution is to make correction bones or use blend shape to correct. Take a look at the new features in this version. Spine quadratic smoothing is added. This is a simple spherical interpolation algorithm, which can effectively improve the body shake smoothing intensity in low-light environment. You need to set it more according to your needs and use smaller values as far as possible. In my current dynamic compensation environment, the light is weak, but my body won't shake too much after the second smoothing. Too high smoothing value will result in less sensitive rotation of the model's body. Add the hand return function, which can improve the problem of finger movement. This function simply means that when the hand is lowered to a certain height, it will automatically return to the initial posture. The return height in the setting is normalized from 0 to E from the spine to the neck. When the wrist is lower than the height you set, the fingers and wrist will automatically switch back to the initial posture. For example, the height is 0.7, which is about this position. Although I'm still clenching my fist, my finger is already below the return height, so it rebounds automatically. If the height is set to E, the finger will rebound when it is lower than the base of the neck. Next, let's take a look at the key features of this version, customize the rendering. Click the avatar in the upper left corner to open the rendering parameter panel. Here are some common rendering parameters that can dynamically adjust the model rendering effect. Click the avatar again to close the rendering parameter panel. Now you can select materials when importing VRM models. Select a model that I randomly made with Roid Studio. After selecting a file, you can see an import setting dialog box. Now it supports three material effects: realism, cartoon without light, and cartoon with light. First, I use realistic style to import. The default model is realistic style. We can adjust stroke, color, shadow, highlight, and many other effects in the parameter panel. Since I am not a TA, I may not translate the names of many parameters accurately enough. You can switch to English to see these parameters. Next, I use the cartoon effect that is not affected by light to import this model again. This is basically the restoration of the original effect of Void Studio. For this effect, you can adjust the cartoon shadow as well as other parameters. It can be seen that this material is not affected by light, in fact, it is empty on lit. Now, look at the cartoon light effect. It is the VRM empty on lit material. This material requires higher lumens of lighting, preset lighting effects, and the lumens are not high, so its effect is not very good. Portrait lighting effect, with white reflective material behind it. Its brightness is the highest among several preset lighting effects. I switched to portrait lighting effect. The light intensity is still not enough, and I may make a normal VRM lighting effect in the future. In this version, I adjusted the physics effect and used kawaii physics to facilitate the subsequent development of the physics parameter adjustment function. At last, I will demonstrate the displacement calibration function. When you turn on the movement switch, a calibration countdown will appear, and the countdown of seconds can be adjusted in the settings. Once the position is calibrated, the character will begin to move.